Final Cut Pro has a lot of really advanced editing techniques that I don't think a lot of people are totally aware of. And so today I wanted to spend a couple minutes and teach you the basics of keyframe animation in Final Cut Pro by showing you how to do a progress bar across the bottom of a video. And you see progress bars like this used a lot in videos posted to social media, where it's an easy way, even without sound, to see how long the video is and how much you've already gone through. It basically is just a bar that goes across the bottom of the screen for the duration of the video. And the way to do that in Final Cut Pro is just to use a generator and then some simple keyframe animation. So before we get started, there are two things about keyframe animation in Final Cut Pro that I think are really important to understand. And the first one is that whenever you move your mouse over a setting in Final Cut and there's a diamond that appears next to it, it's a diamond with a plus sign in the middle of it, that means add a keyframe. And when you realize that and you go through your menu, it's shocking how many different settings you can keyframe throughout Final Cut. It gives you a ton of versatility. If you're unfamiliar with what a keyframe is, basically it's just a marker that tells the software this specific element needs these specific settings at this specific time. And if you have multiple keyframes, the software will handle the changes between those keyframes. And the other thing you need to know about keyframes in Final Cut Pro is that they're not immediately visible. So in order to work with them, you need to right click on your footage and select Show Video Animation. You can also just press Control V to turn that on and off. And that will show you all of the keyframes and all the animation in your footage. So for the sake of this tutorial, I've selected just a random clip from my last video, which is all about the Rodecaster Pro podcasting mixer that is really fun. It's 30 seconds of footage, and so we're gonna create a 30 second progress bar. And there are multiple ways to do this. The way I'm showing you is just my way of doing it, which I find really, really simple. So the first thing is we will need to create the progress bar. And in order to do that, we can just go up to the generator menu and select a custom generator and drag it on top of the video clip that we're gonna use. By default, it's a plain black screen. And so you can change that to whatever color you want your progress bar to be. Typically you'd want a pretty bright color that's easy to see, probably like white, or since I like blue, I'm gonna choose this cyan kind of blue. And then, since your progress bar is a bar and not the entire screen, you can just transform it to whatever size you want and whatever position you want. And for the sake of this tutorial, I'm gonna make the generator pretty narrow and I'm gonna place it just at the bottom of the screen to whatever width or height, I guess, whatever thickness I want it to be. So in the end, basically it's gonna look something like that. When the video is done, the bar will be all the way at the end. So all I'm gonna do is press Control V to show my video clip animation on the generator. I'm gonna drag the generator so that it fills up the entire clip. And what you'll notice is now there's just a solid bar, so we need to animate it. The simple way to do that is to go up into the inspector and start playing with the transform keyframes. So in order to make the progress bar move across the bottom of the screen, we're going to add a keyframe to the position setting under the transform options in the inspector. So if you go up to inspector, you see transform, and then there's position right there, there's X and Y. We're only gonna mess with X, and if I change the value just by clicking and dragging, you can see that it's moving the bar, and it looks like it's progressing across the screen. When the clip is over, this is where we want the bar to be. I'm going to add a keyframe right there. And then you'll notice in my video animation menu, you can see a little blue diamond showed up. That is that keyframe. All I need to do then is drag the keyframe all the way to the very end of the clip. And it's gonna tell the computer that at that point, that progress bar needs to be that wide. And then once you've made one keyframe and you start changing any settings, Final Cut will just add in another keyframe automatically. And so when this progress bar starts, we want it to be totally off the screen. And so now we've got these two keyframes. If I move them really close together, the progress bar is gonna move really fast across the bottom of the screen, but that's not what we want. That's not actually indicating any progress. So I'm gonna drag the second keyframe all the way to the beginning. Sometimes you need to zoom in just to double check that it is actually all the way over to the beginning. Go all the way to the end, make sure this one is actually to the end. And so now when I play the video, you can see the progress bar starts moving across the screen. And because the keyframes are at one end of the clip and the other, by the time the progress bar gets all the way to the end of the video, it is actually the end of the video clip. And that's basically how you animate a progress bar from scratch. It's really, really simple. So I wanted to show you how to make a custom progress bar that you can use on your own, but it also gives you an idea of the basics of keyframe animation within Final Cut Pro. You can keep it really simple like this, or you can go crazy and adjust all these different settings with keyframes. The options are kind of endless. I'm always really impressed with Final Cut Pro, and I love how many advanced things you can do with it in a really simple and really easy workflow. So let me know what you think. If you have any questions, I'm happy to try my best and help out. Otherwise, thanks so much for your time, and I'll see you in the next video. Spinning around. Ooh.